I'm destined to be hated. If you read the books, they'll say it's why I was created. But I don't care.
This is
solve my problem. I need you all off my land and back where you came from.
Back? We can't go back.
Farquaad will turn us into breakfast.
The guy's bad news.
Oh, hey, maybe you could help us.
Oh, yeah. He'll listen to you. Yeah, you're big. And scary.
I'm also an ogre, which means I stay on my swamp and avoid large crowds. Or haven't you all read the stories?
Ha! You mean like the one that said that I'm a big, bad wolf?
Or the one that said I'm a wicked witch!
Or the ones that say I'm a wooden boy? What? I have a glandular condition!
Look here, Ogre. Let me spell it out for you. We don't want us here any more than you do. But you're the only one tough enough to stand up to that no good flim flam of Farquaad.
Tough enough? You don't even know me.
I always dreamed I'd get a happy ending.
Can't you help us out with an ever after?
Can't you see that you're our only hope? You're our only hope. You're our only hope. You're our only hope. You're our only hope.
Okay, I get it. Attention all fairy tale things. Your welcome here is officially worn out. I'm gonna go and see this guy Farquaad and get you all off my land and back where you came from. Swamp. Okay. Fuel up. Good.
Ah! Watch where you're going, Bill! Oh, I'm okay. I'm alright. Stay right there, Bob. Oh. That was a lesson right there. Donkeys should not be climbing trees. We had to do something to escape those goons. Guess it worked because it.
I hear some horses over here!
Oh no. Oh,
it's hideous!
Well, that's not very nice. It's just a donkey.
Step aside, Ogre, and let us out.
Why? What did he do?
I don't want to die.
He's a talking donkey, a freak of nature, much like yourself, you unsavory beast.
Hey! You're going the right way for a smacked bottom, you are.
By the order of Lord Farquaad, I'm authorized to place you both under arrest.
Under arrest, eh? This is the part where you run away.
Ah!
Oh, good. Now, why don't you go celebrate your narrow escape with your friends?
But I don't have any friends.
Now, there's a shocker.
Hey, you lost or something?
No, I'm just trying to figure out the best route to Duloc.
Oh, I know where Duloc is. You gotta let me show you the way, because I'm like a GPS with fur.
I'll be fine on my own, thanks.
But nobody's fine on their own. Not when you look like we do. Did you hear what they were saying? Man, this place is going up Stepford. We gotta join forces. Otherwise, they're gonna put me in a cage, and I cannot be put back in a cage. I don't know if I mentioned this or not, but I spent 6 years in solitary for impersonating a pinata. That was really scary. And if you don't mind me saying, if that doesn't work, your breath will certainly get the job done.
Listen, little donkey, take a look at me. What am I?
Really green?
No! I'm an ogre. You know, grab your torch and pitchfork. Doesn't that bother you?
Nope.
Really?
Really. Man, I like you. What's your name?
Shrek.
Well, you know what I like about you, Shrek? You got that whole, I don't care what anybody thinks of me thing. I like that. I respect that. You all right?
Oh, good. Goodbye.
Hey, you gotta let me go with you. You all know what it's like to be considered a freak. But that's why we gotta stick together. Don't speak. Just count me out. I might surprise you. I'll be a friend when others despise you. Don't look eyes. Stop with your moping. You need a pal. My calendar's open. I'll bring in soup when you feel congested. I'll bail you out when you feel arrested. I got your back when things get scary. And I'll shave it when things get hairy. Like yin and yang, strum and drang, like ang and chang, attached at the hip, but not at all, maybe hip and my train, gonna be on you like a fat kid on cake. Like Cupid and Psyche, like Pop Rocks and Mikey, we'll stick together like that Velcro stuff. I'll be the fuzzy side, you'll be the spiky. One of those little kids in the pajamas with the funny things on the bottom. You know, beanies, or like donuts. Who knows what donuts?
Adventure. Yes, I'm ready. Bring in the cookie.
Catch me, I'm the gingerbread man.
Look what you've done to my legs! You're a monster!
I'm not the monster here, you are. You and the rest of those fairy tale freaks poisoning my perfect kingdom.
It's not a kingdom because you're not a king!
Oh, but I will be. Just as soon as I find a princess to marry. And I hear you know of one. Tell me where she is.
Eat me!
No. I have tried to be fair to you creatures, but now my patience has reached its end.
Well, maybe I have heard tell of a princess.
From who?
Do you know the Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man.
Yes, I know the Muffin Man who lives on Drury Lane.
Well, I heard it from the Muffin Man.
The Muffin Man.
The Muffin Man.
We heard it from the Muffin Man.
Can I go now?
You haven't told me where she is. You must!
I won't!
Tell me, or I'll...
Ah! Not the books! Not my guesswork books!
Then where is the princess?
Okay, I'll tell you. She's a day's walk from here in a dragon guarded castle surrounded by hot, boiling lava.
Well, that sounds dangerous.
You want a princess or not?
Go on.
In the highest room, in the tallest tower, you'll find a fiery redhead named Princess Fiona.
Ooh, Princess Fiona. She sounds perfect. Except for that dragon and lava thing. I'll have to find someone else to go.
Big surprise!
I shall make Fiona my queen, and Duloc will finally have the perfect king. Captain, round up your men, summon the citizens, and bring that cookie to the swamp.
Swamp! That's the thanks I get!
Thelonious, tell the royal coiffure I need to have my hair pressed. We're going to get a queen.
Ah!
Well, this place is weird. Come on, let's go find this Farquaad guy and get out of here.
Ooh, I want to stop at the gift shop and get a t-shirt.
We are not stopping for t-shirts.
Oh, come on.
Dance for every crew.
what you've all been waiting for. The raffle drawing to determine who will have the honor of setting forth to rescue the lovely Princess Fiona from the fiery keep of the dragon.
Excuse me. Roar. Are you Lord Farquaad?
Maybe. Does the name strike fear in your heart?
No, but that little hat does.
Who let this thing in here?
Look, I'll be out of your silky hair just as soon as you give me my swan back.
Your swan?
Yes, when you dump those fairy tale creatures.
Newsflash, Ogre. That oozing mud pit happens to be within the province of Duloc and therefore under, my jurisdiction.
Now look here, half-pint.
Wait a minute.
Wait a minute. Oh, this is too perfect.
What is?
You're big and hulking and wonderfully expendable. People of Duloc, we have a winner. Congratulations, Ogre. You've won the honor of embarking on a great and noble quest.
Well, we're already on a quest.
To give my swamp back.
Yes, and you've nearly accomplished it. You only need to do one more simple little task, and I'll hand over the deed to your swamp.
What exactly is this simple little task?
Oh, Wolfgang! The dossier on Her Royal Highness! My people, your queen is on her way!
Tex-Mex and lazy Sundays.
She sounds fun.
Also says she's been locked up in that tower since age 7.
Aw, that's sad. All alone since 7 years old. 7 years old. 7 years old. 7 years old.
You are so weird.
I can't. Okay. But don't let me go. Don't let me go.
I won't let you go. I won't let you go.
What did I do to deserve you, my pal Evermore? We crossed the bridge together. What a beautiful metaphor.
If it was me, you'd be dead. It's brimstone.
Brimstone. Don't be telling me it's a brimstone. I know what I smell, but it wasn't no brimstone. Didn't come from no stone, either.
Ah, this will come in handy. Hope it's fireproof. All right. You stay here. I'll be right back.
Stay here? You mean by myself?
Unless you'd rather come slay the dragon and rescue the princess.
No, that's okay, I'll stay here. But hurry back! Man, this place is creepy.
You don't know the half of it.
Whoa! Trent, come back!
Hey, it's a new guy! We haven't had a new guy in a couple of years.
Trent, those people are creepy here.
Shh, you gotta wake her up.
She gets really bad.
What are you talking about? Who are you people?
We're knights. We came to rescue the princess.
Just like you.
We didn't make it, though.
We are the lucky ones. The rest of them she incinerated.
She keeps us around because we sing Becca.
I gotta get out of here.
That's what we thought!
Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god!
That's what we did!
And if you didn't know that, you gotta get your eyes checked. And secondly, That girl's not in my type, you know why? I like a big, big girl. I like a big, big girl. That's for the boys.
Up on. Bend it now!
Well, I have to save my ass.
Priests are knights, so down a bit. Shouldn't girls are delicate. I long for this my whole life long. Now you're doing it all wrong. Down or up the feet away. That's what every story thinks. Riding over a furry. Fast a dragon you have slain. You have slain.
It's on my to-do list.
What?
He's the one who wants to marry you.
Why didn't he come and rescue me?
Good question. You can ask him that when we get there tomorrow.
Mark? Oh my gosh, it's almost sunset.
So?
I didn't realize it was so late. We need to make camp.
Camp? But you've just escaped.
Yes, and I felt the whole ordeal quite exhausting. I need to rest immediately.
Well, that's unfortunate, because we're going to keep going.
I advise that we're to camp right now!
Very well. There's a cave right over there.
That's no place for a princess.
No, no, it's perfect. Well, gentlemen, I did think of that.
Do you want me to read you a bedtime story?
I said good night!
By day, one way, by night, another. This shall be the norm until you find true love's first kiss and then take love's true form.
I can get some hair extensions, but I can do it. Who would you want to be?
I don't want to be anybody.
Just a fun one.
I wouldn't.
If you had to.
Donkey.
If a guy had a knife to your throat and was like, you can't be an ogre anymore, pick something else. Who would you pick?
I would pick that guy up and hurl him into a tree.
Man, you're no fun. Is this what it's going to be like? When we save the princess, us sitting around our swamp all day doing nothing.
Our swamp? Donkey, there is no our, there is no we. It's just me and my swamp. And the first thing I'm gonna do when I get back is build a 10-foot wall around my land.
You got me deep, Shrek. You got me real deep. What's your problem anyway? What do you have against the whole world?
Look, I'm not the one with the problem, okay? It's the world that seems to have a problem with me. You saw how the princess reacted. That's the way it always is. People take one look at me and they say, run, help, a big, stupid, ugly ogre! They judge me before they even know me. That's why I'm better off alone.
Well, you know, Shrek, I didn't think you were a big, stupid, ugly ogre.
Yeah, I know.
So there's really no one you'd rather be?
Yes, I'd be a hero with sword and armor clashing. Looking semi-dashing, a shield within my grip. Or else I'd be a Viking and live a life of daring while smelling like a herring. Upon a Viking ship I'd sail away, I'd see the world, I'd reach the farthest reaches. I'd feel the wind, I'd taste the salt and sea, and maybe storm some beaches. That's who I'd be. That's who I'd be. Or I could be a poet and write a different story. One that tells of glory and wipes away the lies. To the skies I'd throw it, the stars would do the telling. The moon would help with spelling, and night would dot the eyes. I'd write a verse, recite a joke, with wit and perfect timing. I'd share my heart, confess the things I yearn, and do it all while rhyming. But we all learn. But we all learn. An ogre always hides. An ogre's fate is known. An ogre always stays in the dark and all alone. See you soon. as I'd be a hero. And if my wish were granted, life would be enchanted, or so the stories say. Of course I'd be a hero, and I would scale a tower to save a hothouse flower and carry her away. But standing guard would be a beast I'd somehow overwhelm it. I'd get the girl, I'd take a breath, and I'd remove my helmet.
Not.
princess, did you by chance eat some of those funny little mushrooms down by the street?
Of course not. I'm just happy that it's a new day full of promises and fresh starts. And the first thing I'd like to do is apologize for my behavior last night. We obviously got off on the wrong foot, and well, I'd like to make it up to you.
You would?
Yes, you are my rescuer after all. So, I gathered a basket of berries for the trip.
Princess, it's beautiful.
Aren't they beautiful, Shrek?
Well, you'll grow to love them, I promise. It will be the way.
So, Princess, do you normally frolic with rats?
And what if I do?
Oh, I don't know, Princess. Germ-infested vermin and all that, it's not exactly what I expected.
Well, maybe you shouldn't judge people before you get to know them.
Mm-hmm.
So, tell me about my groom to be Lord Farquaad. What do you think?
Well, let me put it this way, Princess. Men of Farquaad's stature are in short supply.
Really?
Well, he is a little intimidating.
Well, he must be.
And yet very, very good at small talk. Saying you may want to lower your expectations.
Yeah, like 3 feet or so.
No Christmas card.
birthday.
Yeah, why was sent away on Christmas Eve?
Underground. Daddy didn't talk much,
He barely said hello. He simply muttered, hi-ho. And off to work he'd go. Daddy was grumpy. My mama was a princess who left her crown behind. Daddy was her true love, so mama didn't mind. I never knew my mama, but she could have been a queen. She married way beneath her. Beneath her knee, I mean. Oh, Daddy's bed was lumpy, so Mommy couldn't sleep. Daddy built a new one, so tall and so steep. 20 mattresses she slept upon. One night she rolled over, and Mama was gone. So Daddy was grumpy. Me and my old man. You abandoned me in the woods, Daddy. Well, I crawled out and up. Oh, if you could only see me now, Daddy. I'd invite you to the wedding, but you have to be this tall to get in. To the races, guards! Without a minor, minor. Tags of royal lackeys, playing violin. Who will not let you win? Aha! Aha! Aha!
It's, Duloc.
Oh.
Yeah, me neither.
Congratulations, Princess. Your future awaits.
Yes. It does.
Oh, well, so much for that batch of snuggers I was going to make us.
Snuggers?
Oh, they're a traditional ogre campfire snack. They're just like s'mores, except that instead of marshmallows and chocolate, we use squirrel gizzards and mulch. They melt in your mouth.
I think I need to sit down a minute.
No sitting. We have to get the princess to do one.
No, wait, Trek! I may not get another chance to try one of those snuggers.
Princess, if you try one of those, you may not get another chance to do anything.
Zip it, donkey.
Well, I was just thinking that maybe Nora could wait until morning.
Morning?
Yeah, why not? I spent my whole life without true love. What's one more night?
I'll find us some dinner.
I'll look at the firewood.
Oh, sorry. Say what?
Yeah.
There's something going on around here. I've been watching and the signals are clear. A nervous laugh when she brushes her skin. A sweaty palm, that big dumpy grin. With a giggle and a flip of her hair, I smell the pheromones in the air. Making Google eyes over their food. I need their help in setting the mood. Don't believe me, love is blind. Well, I got three friends who think otherwise. And here they are, direct from my imagination.
Free by night, free by night. See how they run.
You gotta turn up the heat, you gotta bottle the pain, you gotta make up the move and don't be afraid. Reach for a hand, baby, go for a kiss. She's
waiting for a
good
day.
You can do it.
Nutty, right?
Mm-hmm. I guess I'll be dining a little differently tomorrow night.
You know, maybe you could come visit me in the swamp sometime. I'll cook all sorts of good things for you. Swamp toad soup, fish eye tartare, you name it.
I'd like that.
Shrek, I hope you can hear me better. But if you could, I'd want to say a few things here. I am in your corner, buddy, but you've got to tell this girl how you really feel. You may not get another chance, so go on now. Open your heart and... here we go.
Yeah,
sure. All right,
get it
done. Okay.
Are you gonna eat that?
Man, what is wrong with you? You got to make a move. You gotta shoot the deer. You gotta bubble the deer. You gotta
move the deer. Step it
out of a book
into something.
Come on, come on, come on, baby. We're gonna make a move. Come on, come on, make a move.
going on here? You're afraid of the dark, aren't you?
Oh, yes, yes, that's it. I'm terrified. I'd better get going.
Don't worry, Princess. I used to be afraid of the dark, too. Wait a second. I'm still afraid of the dark.
I'm sorry, but I have to go.
Oh, okay.
Good night.
Good night. Now, no, sir, I did not come all this way dealing with your body odor to let you let her walk away like that.
What are you talking about?
I am an animal. I have instincts, and I can clearly tell that you two are digging each other right now.
You're crazy. I'm just bringing her back to Farquaad.
Uh-huh. So you don't have any feeling for her whatsoever?
Look, even if I did, and I'm not saying I do because I don't, she's a princess, and I'm...
an ogre.
Yes, an ogre.
She needs to know.
Where are you going?
To get more wood before your fire dies.
Sorry about that, fat man.
going. Come on, help inside myself. I have to blame the gene pool, which reminds me of...
Ugh, where am I going with this?
When words fail, what will I do? When words fail, how will she know how I feel? When words fail, will I fail too? Do I have a snowball's chance? Are my prospects just too grim? I spent my life stuck in the mud. Words fail, she'll know what I mean. If words fail, she'll just take my hand. She sees me like nobody else has. If words fail, she'll understand. She'll understand.
Captain, ride ahead and tell them it's a code red.
Code red!
right, the sooner the better. There's so much to do, for tomorrow we wed.
This is better than a good night's sleep. What I miss?
Fare thee well, Ogre.
Shrek, what are you doing? You're letting them get away, Shrek! Come on, you can still catch them!
I can still see them, they're not moving that fast!
They're still backing up! They're gone. Shrek, what are you doing? You let them get away!
Look, there's something you don't know. I talked to her last night.
Yeah, I know you talked to her last night. You're great pals, aren't you? Well, why don't you follow her home?
Well, Trek, I want to go home with you.
Hey, I told you before, I live alone. My swamp, understand? Nobody else. Especially not useless, pathetic, annoying, talking donkeys.
But I thought...
Yeah, you know what? You thought wrong. Build me a wall, I'll make it 10 feet high. See you later, pal, bye-bye. No one getting in, so don't you even try. A 10-foot wall. I'm gonna dig me a moat, I'll make it 10 feet deep. Maybe then I'll get some sleep. Perona keeping guard, so look before you leap into my boat. Give an inch and they drag me a mile. When I'm out in the world, I'm under attack. When a face that launched 1,000 insults, well, bon voyage, I'll never come in.
Yeah. do. We wait for miracles. We wish upon stars. Why, I remember my cricket always used to tell me
that. Oh, forget that cricket.
Yes?
If he was so smart, he would have seen that windshield coming.
No, we just need to lay low until this ball blows over. Why can't I be a real boy?
Listen up, puppet! We spend our
recognize a ball when you saw one.
Well, yeah, but the wall is supposed to go around my swamp, not through it.
It is, around your hat. See, this is my hat, and that's your hat.
Oh, your hat.
Yeah, your hat. I helped save the princess. I did half the work. I get half the booty.
Back off!
No, you back off.
Stubborn jackass!
Smelly ogre!
This is my swamp!
There you go again. My. Me. Well, now it's my turn, so you can just shut up and pay attention. You are mean to me, you disrespect me, and you don't appreciate anything that I do. You're always pushing me around or pushing me away. You're so wrapped up in layers, Onion Boy, you're afraid of your own feelings.
Oh yeah? Well, if I treated you so bad, then how come you came back?
Because that's what friends do. They forgive each other.
Go away.
There you go again. Just like you did with Fiona. What'd she do? Like you? Maybe even love you?
Love me? She said I was ugly, a hideous creature. I heard the two of you talking.
She wasn't talking about you. She was talking about something else.
She wasn't talking about me? Well, then who was she talking about?
No, I'm not saying anything. You didn't want to listen to me, right?
Don't you?
Right?
Look, I'm sorry, all right?
No.
I'm sorry. I guess I am just a big, stupid, ugly ogre. Can you forgive me?
I mean, that's the friends too, right?
Right. Friends?
Friends.
Oh, God!
This is nice. Mm-hmm. Oh, Shrek, I'm so glad you came. I only brought out 3 bricks.
That's not much of a wall, is it? That's okay. It's okay.
Good.
So, what did Fiona say about me?
Oh, you're asking me. You should go ask her.
Ask her?
Well, I'd be a hero. Now's your chance.
The wedding! Ah, oh, donkey, we'll never make it in time.
Now, what kind of noble steed would I be if I didn't have a plan? Follow me!
But you can't marry him.
Why not?
Because Because he's only marrying you so he can be king.
That is outrageous!
Don't listen to him, Fiona.
He's not your true love.
And what do you know about true love?
Well,
Oh, this is precious! The ogre has fallen in love with the princess, oh good lord! Guards, take this abomination out of my sight!
No! Wait, let's hear what the monster has to say. It might be worth a laugh.
Oh, you are awful. You heard her, ogre. Express yourself with as few grunts as possible. Apologize!
Okay, maybe not. But I'm not a freak. I'm not. I have a castle.
Bring out the lantern.
Stop the wedding!
Fiona? Well, that explains a lot.
Ew, it's disgusting. All this hocus pocus alters nothing. This marriage is binding, and that makes me king. See? And as for you, my wife, I'll see you locked back in that tower for the rest of your days.
Actually, no, you won't.
What are you doing, you insolent beast? I'll see you drawn and quartered. I am king. I will have order. I will have perfection. I will have what I want.
Thank you.
best friend.
And his best friend.